Right, this video is a little bit of a follow-up on the Econ Archimedes restoration project. In the last video I mentioned a music program called Maestro. Maestro is a music making application and it has MIDI support. I thought, hey, it'd probably be a fun idea to try out what it can do in terms of MIDI. I have played with it in advance a little bit. Sadly, Maestro does not seem to support MIDI input, only MIDI output, but still I think it's good enough to just try a few things. I got the iPad here with the Roland Sound Canvas app. Well, I've got this here. Unfortunately, that will only work with the iPad because of the fact that Maestro does not appear to have any MIDI input capabilities. I was hoping I could perhaps play a bit on the iPad like this and that Maestro would record it, but unfortunately that doesn't work. And what I've got here is my Rephase DX synthesizer. Again, I was hoping I could use that with Maestro to do input and record MIDI, but well, it will work just fine as a MIDI output device. So how did I connect everything? I'm going to use the iRig MIDI 2 from IK Multimedia, which is a very simple MIDI interface that is compatible with iOS devices. It has MIDI input and MIDI output capabilities. Both cables are connected to the back of the Econ Archimedes. So let's have some fun with it. On the sound canvas, I have already preset a few random instruments. They are just different sounds. Right, I'd say let's start. First thing I'll have to do is load up Maestro. I've already got the right disk in the drive. I think I'm just going to put a few notes on the screen first. So, this is Maestro. It's loading now. And we can bring it up. As you can see, it's very basic. We just have a blank canvas with notes. We need to make a few setup options for the instruments, of course. So let's press the right mouse button and go to instruments. And by default, everything is set to MIDI channel 1. I of course want to change that so everything becomes a different channel. So, the first one I can just leave as it is. The second one will be MIDI channel 2. Then the third one MIDI channel 3. And then MIDI channel 4. Hey, I wonder if I could just type this in. No. Why can't I just type this? You have to use the mouse. It's a bit strange that you have to use the mouse to cycle through the MIDI channels. Wouldn't it be easier if you could just use the keyboard to type it in? Perhaps? I don't know, but I don't know what the designers were thinking with that. So, instruments have been set up. Of course, it's a completely blank canvas. I can play something on the Korg NanoKey Studio, but of course, since Maestro does not support MIDI input, this is kind of useless. I just have to use the mouse and paint notes on the screen. So, let's just put some random composition on the screen like that. This is going to sound absolute rubbish because I just don't know what I'm doing. Let's paint some notes. So let's change to a different type. I must say it is really slow. It is not particularly fast. So let's do some 8 notes. Couple of those. Boom, 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 boom. You see how slow it goes? It is literally painting the notes on the screen. And every time you put a note, you see the hourglass cursor thinking and crunching and processing all that data. So I think I'll have a decent amount of notes now, so let's play it. We press the right mouse button and this is kind of irritating, to be fair. Volume, well, maximum tempo, well, just pick something random, play, and this takes a bit. Well, it is playing from the iPad using the Roland Sound Canvas app. Of course, this plays kind of slowly, but we can make it faster. Tempo. Well, this already sounds more interesting, doesn't it? Well, I think that was it. But what does it sound like with the Reface keyboard? First, I'm going to pick a different sound. That seems all right. Tubular bells, let's play it. Oh, actually, I did not connect this properly. Now it's connected properly. Doesn't sound too bad, doesn't it? But that's of course because it's an FM synthesizer. Right, let's see if we could pick a different sound. This is some kind of pad sound called cloud pad. Let's increase the tempo just a little bit more. What about the star pad? And let's make it really fast too. Future Bell. It's one of my favorite sounds alongside the Tubular Bell patch. And of course you can change the FM algorithms on the fly with this synthesizer. Alright, but what does it sound like with a proper composition, something classical, like Bach or Beethoven? Well, the Archimedes has got you covered with that. Let's remove our rubbish composition and let's look at a real composition. Of course, before loading a different song, it asks me if I want to save my old rubbish composition. Of course, I do not want that. Are you sure current music is unsaved? Yes. Alright, that took a bit, but now a composition from Bach has loaded. Let's play it. It takes a while though. I've been messing a little bit with the parameters of the sound, and as you can see, it changes quite a bit. FM synthesis can get pretty crazy after just tweaking a few parameters. Now it's more like space Bach, but maybe that's not really doing Bach justice. Let's go back to the Roland sound canvas. Well, that sounds a little bit more classical, doesn't it? And Mr. Blinky here is showing that there's MIDI data flowing through all these cables, through all these systems. Ooh, Mr. Blinky! You can change the tempo on the fly, but the software isn't quite fast enough to process it instantly. When you click the menu, it needs a little time to process things. Right, I think Mr. Bach is finished. What have we learned from this? Well, the Akon Archimedes can be a great tool for composing music, even though the limitation with Maestro is that it doesn't have any MIDI input capability. You have to paint the notes with the mouse. But just imagine if you had a better like a piece of software, like a proper MIDI sequencer, then this could be actually a really powerful system. Maybe just as powerful as an Atari ST and just be a thing in your studio perhaps. Of course you shouldn't be using Maestro then, but let's say some other like MIDI program. To be fair, I haven't really looked into that, but I'm sure there are probably some better programs out there for the Archimedes. All you need to do really is have the IO module installed that has all the BBC Micro IO things, and you can easily botch into MIDI ports, as my dad did. The hardware is already on the circuit board. You just have to solder in the two connectors, apparently. But then you're all set. You just need 2 5-pin DIN cables and some equipment, and you're good to go. So, I hope you enjoyed it, and thanks for watching. Bye-bye.